Hi everyone, I'm going to make an art journal page. I'm using my mixed media notebook that Maria sent me. I'm in love with this notebook, and it's good that she sent me because we don't have it here. And I'm going to make a background from tissue paper. Now I don't care about the color. I already know that I'm going to cover it up with paint. What I do want is a lot of texture in the background. I'm going to wrinkle this, and I want to glue it and make lots and lots of wrinkles, and then I'll have texture that I can pick up later with something like an ink pad. That's what I'm planning. So I've wrinkled it, and now it's time for a lot of glue. Tissue paper, sometimes it bleeds, sometimes it doesn't. Until you try it, you don't know if what you bought will bleed or not. So I don't know if this will bleed paint, but I'm using what I have. I really don't care, as I said. This is going to get covered with paint. What I do want is to have lots of wrinkles with the tissue paper. If you don't have tissue paper, you can use the white backing of paper napkins or paper towels. And you can even use a wrapping paper, the thin kind. Just wrinkle it and start putting it on your page. So I'm starting here, and I'm moving it so I will have coverage, but I will have lots of wrinkles, and I don't care if it tears. I can take another piece of paper, of the tissue paper, and just glue where I have a rip. So as you can see, I'm moving it on my page to have lots and lots of wrinkles. So now I'm just flattening it out, and I can also take some plastic bag like so, and a brayer, just to make everything in place. Here we go. So now I just need to trim the excess, and then I'm going for the paint. And as usual, always in there is a little bit in the corners that needs more glue. And let's make another wrinkle if I'm going to do it. So usually I will put glue on top of it. Right now it turned out quite fine without, so I'm just moving along and I'm flipping the page so it will be easier to trim the excess. And I'm doing it gently. Tissue paper is kind of delicate, and I don't want to rip anything else. And of course, my page is still wet from the glue. It would have been better if I waited for everything to dry. Right now I'm just continuing. If I'll see I can't manage it, then I'll just give it a strike from my heat gun. We'll see. And here I've got just loose end, and oops. Little bit more here. Okay, so it seems it does need another coat, because my wrinkles are moving here, so I want to make sure it won't move. I'm going to add a little bit of water to my white glue. This is regular white glue. And I'm adding water so it will slide and not tear everything apart and drag it. That's how I'm also using white glue when I'm doing anything with paper napkins. Because they are delicate, I'm diluting the white glue with a little bit of water so the glue and the brush won't drag and just slide on top. So I'm just going to go all over this, then dry it, and then I'll come back. I'm back. So this is dry, and I want to paint it. I'm using a DecoArt. I'm starting with cool blue. And I'm also thinking about adding a little bit water. These are a kind of runny acrylics, but I still want to add a little bit of water. I don't want an acrylic that will be very thick, so it won't clog my texture. So I'm starting at this corner with this color, and still needs a little bit of water. And the only thing I'm planning right now is just painting from here and starting to make it what darker. Yeah, darker, that's what I was going for. So a little bit of water, and now I'm adding a little bit of here. I've got from Crimson Prussian Blue, so just a little bit, and it doesn't want to go out, of course. I'll take another one. Let's see. I've got Copenhagen Blue from DecoArt. So that's what I'm going to add here. Just a drop. And it needs more. As I said, I want it to get darker and darker as I go. And I'm using a soft brush and going all directions so it will get inside all the wrinkles I've created with the tissue paper. Now the water are also helping me blend the colors. It's still wet and can be blended on top here. Now for the variation, for more tones of to this page, I'm adding now a Regal Purple by DecoArt to my blue and putting it here in the corner, and I want a little bit more. And now I'm blending it with the rest. And I want a little bit more of the darker blue here. And here. Yeah. So that's what I was aiming for, and somehow I managed it. So I'm going to let this dry completely and then I'll come back. I'm back. So I want to pick up the texture I have on this page. My page curled a little bit, so I put the paper bulldog clips here to hold it in place. And there is several ways to pick up texture. One is taking an ink pad and moving all over the areas with the texture. The other one is using some gilding wax, yeah, gilding wax, and with your finger going all over the texture. And the other thing you can do is take some acrylic paint, but you need the heavy one, not the runny ones like the quart, and a brush, and put very little on the brush and start moving all over your texture. I'm going to try and pick up the texture with an ink pad, and I've got this very cheap ink pads for children. I'm gonna try and use it because I don't get to use it and it's just laying around. If not, then I will use my Memento Nautical Blue here. And let's see if it will work. I'm taking the black one and it smears here because I wasn't very careful. But it seems like it's working and it's picking up the texture I've got on the page. So I don't push it down, I'm just sliding it over the wrinkles I've got here. And from time to time it will color in between the wrinkles. But as long as you don't push it down, then you are still keeping the interest and the texture and not ruining whatever you've done here. So that's good. Now I'm going to try and switch to the darker blue and we'll see if it will work. If not, I will just go back to the black. And it doesn't work, so back to the black. It will just be more dramatic all these wrinkles texture with the black. Trying to flatten my page so again it will pick only the texture and not anything else. Now you can see it more easily on here where the background is lighter. basically this is it. That's the background in terms of the texture and the wrinkles. Yeah, just a few areas that I wanted to be more more noticeable on my page. Little wrinkles here that I wanted to pick up, and here. Okay, so that's that, and I'm moving this aside. And my focal point, where I wanted hearts. Now I just cut out hearts from a cardboard. This was a cardboard that just comes when you order shirts, and this cardboard is just inside the folded shirt, and I'm always keeping them, and as you can see, using them for the craft. And it's easier if you want a symmetrical hearts, it's easier to just play around on printer paper or something that you can just fold until you're satisfied with the shape, cut it, and then you have a template. That's what I've done. Now I've got these two hearts that I want here, and I also want them with the same texture I've done here. So I'm going to pick a tissue paper, and I prefer to take something in the color which it's going to be, and it's going to be with red colors. So I'm just taking a piece of the red tissue paper, moving all this mess aside, and I'm going to do the same thing I've done to this page. I'm going to take a piece, wrinkle it, and glue it down to each of these hearts, and then I'm going to color it to add color, and these are going to be my focal point. So these are going to take also some time, and you've already seen how I'm doing this technique. So all this gluing and wrinkling I'm going to do now off camera, and I'll be back. I'm back. So I already made one heart, and I'm going to show you how I made this one. As I said, this was the cardboard, and I just glued down a red tissue paper and wrinkled it. Now it's dry. And I've picked two colors by DecoArt. This is Redbird, and this is Bright Red. What I've done is I've picked one side to be darker than the other, and I started to paint it. Basically, what I've done with the background, I want some color, and I wanted to gradually go from dark to a lighter color. So now I'm putting on this side the bright red, and just covering this part. Okay, so I'm going to give it a blast from my heat tool, and so we can continue. Let's see. Okay, let's hope this is dry enough. Moving this aside, Now I wanted it more dimensional, so I took my Stabilo all and went around the edges again. More, I've put more on the left side, like so, and on the right side I've put less of it, but still something that will give more definition to the heart. Here I've just done it very gently. You can do this with a makeup sponge and an ink pad. You can just ink around the edges. So now I'm picking up water on my pin brush so I can activate the Stabilo oil. And I'm just going around. And if you think it's too much, take just a baby wipe and go over and remove whatever you don't like. So at first I thought that I will keep on and do the wrinkles on the hearts with the same thing here. Just go over with a black ink pad, but then I wanted some contrast and I wanted the hearts to be a little bit more lighter, so I went with the gilding wax that I have. Now this is quite an expensive product. I've picked it up when I was on vacation in Vienna, but I've made a video of how to make this stuff from oil pastels, and let's see, here it is. Of course it's not the same as this and it's not the same quality, but it's good enough to work in my arsenal. And these are the ones I've made, and I hope I'll remember. I'll put the link below for this. And I'll just, this time here I've used the gilding wax, and here I'm going to use mine, the one I've done from oil pastels and coconut oil. So as you can see, it's not as bright as the gilding wax, but I don't care. I think it's good enough for this project. Now when you're using either this or the gilding wax, I recommend sealing it with fixative or cheapest hairspray that you can find. And let's see, something like that I want. And I also have, I just bought this, I got this key for chip, whatever they call, some kind of a wood cutout, and I really want to use it here. I'm thinking I'll also paint it with the red and give it highlights with the gold. And this will need several coats. As you can see, it doesn't take well to the acrylic paint. Maybe I should have gessoed it first or used a thicker acrylic paint. So I'm going to work on this piece until it gets to the point when it's red and not just this pale, I don't know what to even call it. So I'll be back. I'm back. So I kept dabbing on this wood chip with a denser kind of red acrylic paint, so it also got a little bit of texture that works for me, because then I've just went over it like on the hearts with the gilding wax, the gold gilding wax. So now I've got this piece, and I still want more interest to my background. and I wanted to stamp around, but with all this texture, it's going to be a problem. Not that I'm really concerned about a perfect print, but I still wanted something to be nice behind the hearts. So I figured I've taken some of my swirly stamps and stamped them on a white layer from a paper napkin. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this prints I've made out of the paper napkin, and I'm going to use a paintbrush and water to go around and take out the image that I want to use on my background gently. And now I'm going to glue this down. So, and I'm hoping it works most of the time when you use the white backing of a paper napkin and use white glue, it will just disappear into the background. So, but sometimes you depends on the quality of the paper napkin. Sometimes it's still a seen. So let's hope this one will work. And I'm just going to glue this down, putting down glue all over this area where my hearts are going to be. And I'm going to just give them some kind of more interesting background with this. So putting this right here, and now gently, because I've got texture and it's a paper napkin, I'm going to slide on top with the glue like so. And this is going to take me some time to finish, and I'm running out of time with the recording on my smartphone. Sometime I really need to find another way to make these videos. My smartphone is not good enough for this stuff. So I'm going to let this needs to dry, but I'm not finished, and I want more of this swirly stamping I've done. So again, I'm going to take the image out of the paper napkin, and I'm going to continue and do the same thing. So I'm going to return once I've got all the swirly stamping in the back. I'm back. So I've finished gluing all the pieces down, all the swirly stamping in the back, my two hearts and this key. And it took a little, well, a lot of time for all the glue to settle down, but it was worth the wait. And this is it. That's my page. I hope it will give you some ideas to play around. This tissue texture technique I've learned from Cat Hand. If you are just beginning with journaling, mixed media, and if you are just beginning with all this stuff, I really urge you to go and look for Cat Hand channel and her mixed media morsels series. That's how I started and learned. So this is it for now. I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for leaving me comments below, and I'll be seeing you in my next video. Bye for now.